The pandemic seems to be here to stay for quite a long time, but that does not mean that we as human beings cannot see bright things in our life in the near future. The first and the foremost positive impact this pandemic has had is on the environment. Global carbon emissions have been coming down drastically and has reduced almost by 50%. That's a very positive note. Thereby, we are able to save Mother Nature. We can save certain parts of global emission and also climate change. Statistics say that the levels of emission from the developed countries are also coming down. The rivers that have been polluted elsewhere is turning cleaner and safer. And the tourists who used to pollute the canals in Venice, in Italy, have stopped coming, and flora and fauna has started coming back to those places. Everywhere there is greenery. Plants are growing. Trees are flowering. Everything seems to be good. So this is one positive aspect. Mother Nature is rejuvenating herself because of this pandemic. We need to see that as a very positive impact. So next session today is going to be the table topic session. A table topic master would be here, and he would give you a topic at random and call anybody in the audience and the members who are present here to speak on a subject or a topic for a minimum of 1 to 2 minutes. And today's topic master is Toastmaster Satyaraj, who is a software engineer, is a very passionate about speech, public speaking, and also about taking up roles in our club meetings. I now request Toastmaster Satyaraj to conduct the TT session. Over to you, Toastmaster Satyaraj.
Thank you, dear Modi. Very good evening, Toastmaster and guest. The purpose of Topic Master is to facilitate table topics where guests and members will have the opportunity to practice their impromptu speaking. In table topic, set of rules will be there. In timing rule, the table topic speaker should limit no more than 2 minutes. At 1 minute, raise the green screen. At 1 minute 30 second, raise the yellow screen. At 2 minute, raise the red screen. After the red screen, we will give 30 seconds for grace time. You will wind up your speech. Next, voting. Each table topic speaker, at least you could speak 1 minute. Then only you will be eligible for voting. If you cross the two minutes 30 seconds, you are not eligible for voting. Today TT sessions, I have splitted two segments. So the first segment, before I will go to the first segment, I need some volunteers to participate this TT session. Any volunteers? If you want gratitude to Toastmaster Abhilash, can you please join this fun part?
Yes. Anyone? Yes. Master Satyaraj, yes.
No, this is not for you. Some others, if you want to gratitude to you.
My God. No one will.
I will join.
I would like to show gratitude.
Okay. Can you, sir, can you make spotlight for them? Ashwini and Toastmaster Nanda. Poster. Thank you. So now I'll go this first segment. The Toastmaster will give an icebreaker speech into their club. It is unusual. Today, vice versa, our Toastmasters will deliver on behalf of Toastmaster. So today I picked a Toastmaster Abhilash. So both of them will deliver Toastmaster Abhilash icebreaker speech. Each one take 2 minutes. You can briefly explain the each icebreaker speech.
Should I have to consider myself as Abhilash? Should I have to introduce Abhilash
yes.
into the stage?
No, yourself will consider Abhilash.
Okay. So Good evening, fellow Toastmasters here. So I am Abhilash, presenting in front of you with a broad smile and cheerfulness as always. And I am the presiding officer of the committee. And I would like to welcome all the guests and fellow Toastmasters here for the meeting number 780. And I would like, here I recognize the presence of our area director, Naidira Shah, and distinguished Toastmaster, Nina John. And our speakers today are young enthusiasts going to talk about various different interesting topics like sleep cycle, like number of amount of salt in our food, and about how to go into veganism, etc. I would now ask the Toastmaster of the day to introduce yourselves, and back to you, Toastmaster of the day. Back to you, Tabletop Master. Thank you.
Thank you. Nanda, you can continue.
Good evening, Toastmasters and guests. I am Toastmaster Abhilash, the most eligible bachelor in CTM. When I joined CTM, I wanted to get rid of my public speaking fear. But what happened is completely unexpected. It completely transformed me in such a way that I am no more the old Abhilash I used to be. When I joined, I was sitting probably in a corner, just quietly watching with my glasses on what is happening and praying to God that he would not call me for TT. But now, today, what I am is completely different. I am being elected as a president of the club, and I also been a successful VP education of the club. And this transformation cannot be expressed in pure words. I would like to express my gratitude to all my fellow XCOM members and also to all the members of CTM who made this transition possible. Yes, the old Abhilash has become a new, completely new version of myself. I no more have any fear of public speaking, and in fact, I go to make speeches. This transformation is possible only because of each one of you in this club. And I would like to express my deep gratitude and love to each one of you. And once I make more such progress and one day become a district director, over to you, favorite topic minister.
Thank you, Ashwini and Toastmaster Nanda. So you are tremendous to create a case story of our upcoming president. Now I will be moved to the second segment. Before moving to the second segment, I want to kudos to some of them. They are very much interested before they start the sessions. CB will send the message to me, so I am much interested. This is very happy moment to most of the time. Toastmasters are very fear about that. Even though they deliver great speeches, also there some fear is there. But the guest will be interested to message me. So all of them give kudos to guest CB. Now I'll be go to the topic. Now I will call to Toastmaster Vijayarajan. Vijayarajan.
Good evening, Satyaraj, Toastmaster.
Very good evening. So your topic is, how do you treat people who can do nothing for you? Once again, I'll repeat. How do you treat people who can do nothing for you?
Good evening, Toastmasters. Yeah, thank you, Toastmaster Satyaraj. Before that, I'm not a guest, actually. I'm a member of CTM. maybe that is my attendance. Okay. Good evening, Toastmaster and my dear guests. There is one saying by great philosopher that there are two things you can judge people. That is, once when you give power, you give enormous power to a person, and just you can get what kind of person, what kind of character the person has. The other time is you can judge a person when you find them, how they treat the people whom who will not be helpful for them in any way. How you treat a common man, how you treat a person who is not going to be helpful or useful by any ways, the third person. When you observe that, that is the real character, that is the real personality of a person, that is a real place where you can find the, whether the person is genuine or not. So I think Toastmaster Satyaraj has given the insight, has reminded me of that particular saying of a great philosopher. that we have to only when we observe people we can make a right judgment when how they deal with a person who is not useful by any ways. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
Thank you, J. Rajan. So now I'll be move for next question, next topic. I should call Toastmaster Puneet.
Yes, Table Topic Master. Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are audible and visible.
Super.
Your topic is, who lights you up? Once again, I'll repeat. Who lights you up?
Carl Jung beautifully said that one who looks outside dreams, whereas one who looks within awakens. We don't need external people to lighten us. Yes, sometimes you do require it, but at the end of the day, it all boils down to the internal motivation, that internal discipline, which makes us to conquer our most boring task. For example, one of the most dreaded thing which I hate to do in the morning is bathing. I know it sounds a little weird. I hate bathing. And more importantly, I hate waking up on time. My father scolds me very bad and ugly. Why are you are sleeping like a buffalo? Even you can create a Guinness Book of World Record and you can even defeat Kumkarna, because I have that kind of worse sleeping habits, because I'm a night owl. I normally read everything or prepare. Or normally I'm a person, if you're an engineering student, chances are that you would always make being a night owl as a priority. So that kind of habit also entered in my corporate life. Somehow I managed it because I was an external boss who I was accountable. With regards to your family and loved ones, you can take a little bit of breathing space. How much ever your father scolds you, even if you are not changing, at the end of the day, he's still your father. Your father will forgive you and he'll beat you next day up again. But having said that, over a course of time, I realized that waking up on time, being highly motivated to, is my responsibility, not my father, because he may not be there. So there's one person whom I look up to lighten up. Of course, there are mentors like Nina Ma'am, and there are so many amazing people in Toastmasters, but how long will they be with you? We have come alone in this world, so we'll be going alone in this world as well. So of course, take help from people who lightens up. There are many amazing people who are on the screen right now. If I name everybody, I'm pretty sure I'll be time disqualified, even the timer as well. But having said that, no doubt take help from all these people. After all, you are the average of five people whom you surround with. But at the end of the day, remind yourself that you have come alone in this world and you live alone in this world. So be your own self-motivator, because you don't need motivation from somebody else when you have that inner motivation. Back to you, Table Topic Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Puneet. You also most of time to motivate to us to spontaneously to take the table topic. Thank you. I'll be move for next topic. Before I'll move to topic, I should call Toastmaster Adil. Toastmaster Adil?
Yes, TT Master.
So your topic is, what would you do if fear did not stop you? I'll repeat again. What would you do if fear did not stop you?
Thank you, Table Topic Master, and a very good evening to all the fellow Toastmasters. Just a few minutes back when Satyara dropped a message, if anyone would like to volunteer for Table Topics, drop out your name. I just asked him, bro, I'm very tired today. Do not call me. Out of fear. What he heard was, okay, let me call for third speaker. So, Satyaraj, I'm back to CTM. Soon you're going to see my rage. I'm going to take TTM role very soon. So, speaking about this fear, I've researched throughout my life, like, what is this fear thing which is running your mind? Whatever the new thing you're going to do. So it was 2016, if I'm not wrong. There was a cousin's wedding. So there were thousands of people were there, because it was a very grand wedding. There were people dancing, music, all those things. And we are surrounded by family and friends. And you know how close I am with my grandmother. So that was the time when she was sitting there. I had that, because at that time, there were a lot of people who were speaking, oh, next is your marriage. I was like, what? So very soon. So I was very scared. So what I did was I sat near my grandmother and asked her, "Grandma, what is the thing about this fear? How it was in your generation?" Satyaraj, for your information, because I haven't revealed this thing anywhere in my Toastmaster journey previously, my grandma came near to me and she came near to my ears and said that one thing. That was the time the music was very loud in the wedding hall. I was not able to hear that answer from her. So unfortunately, I'm not going to say that today. Soon I'll check with her again, like what was the fear factor in their generation, and let you know the answer. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you. Very good attempt. Next, I will call one more. Any senior Toastmaster? Anyone interested? Or else I will jump into guest. Okay, I will move to guest. Then I will be back to Toastmasters. I will call guest CB on stage. Guest CB. Okay, I will move next. Guest Akash. Hello.
Guest I think Akash has left. We can call another person.
Okay. Thank you. Guest Mithun, sorry.
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay.
Your topic is do something green today. Do something green today.
Green today, okay. The best green thing you can do is just sit at home, because you don't have to do anything. Nature can repair itself. That's what this lockdown has taught us. When the last time when the lockdown was there for over a year, things the world has seen that things got back to normal. So before that, there was a belief that as a human, we had to do something. We had to take things into our hands and repair things. But nature showed us that you don't have to do anything. Just sit at home. I'll take care of myself. And if you don't, then nature, if you try to destroy nature, nature will destroy you. So the best thing that you can do is even if you don't contribute anything, just don't destroy anything. That's it. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
Thank you. I will call next guest. Any volunteer for guest?
Nina ma'am has raised her hand.
Okay, well, I will be first. I'll go with guest, then I'll be back.
Guest first.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. I will call some guest. Guest Jaya Murugan. Hello.
Why don't we have guest Sivalay?
Oh, Sivalay. Okay, fine.
Yes. Good evening. Yes. Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah. Your topic is be silent in two situations. I will repeat again. Be silent in two situations. Your stage is yours.
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are audible and visible.
Is this for me? I'm Jay Murugan. Is this for me?
Yeah. Yes. This is for you.
Okay. Silence is the best answer when you are and you're we can eat anger before.
I think there appears to be some audio issues with our guest. So you can go to the next one. We probably see if he comes back.
Okay.
So that will save a lot of things. And the second factor is
when you face toughness, better be in silent, build up yourself, and come back, rebound with vigor. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Kudos to you. Good try. I will call one more guest. Guest is Siddesh. Siddeshwar. Hello. I should call guest Siddeshwar. No. Okay, I will be move next guest. Guest Sivalai. Sivalai Sandil Nathan. Hello.
Yeah, yes. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Your topic is? If you don't love it, you are going to fail. If you don't love it, you are going to fail. Stage is yours.
Thank you, whatever topics, Master. Absolutely. If I'm not going to love, I'm going to fail in my office. See, I don't like when my boss scolds me. And every time he scolds, I always think that I have to throw the papers and I have to shout back and I have to give the resignation letter and come out. But that is not the case, because if I have to do, almost every day I have to do. So what I do, I love my job. And I love my boss whenever he scores. Instead of finding fault with what he says or how he says, I see what is that he's expecting from me. And I change myself so that I can keep improving myself and I can perform better. This, if I say this as in the professional front, in my personal life also, you see that. In fact, I thought that the earlier topic of the two situations where you have to be silent, I was just thinking what I would have said. Same thing I say here, but whenever my wife speaks sense, it is better to keep silent. And similarly, to relevant to my topic, I have to love whether she speaks sense or otherwise. Otherwise, I cannot enjoy my life. So back to Toastmaster. Sorry, double topic master. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, I will call to DTM Nina John on stage.
Yes, sir.
Your topic is a secret you have not told many people. I'll repeat again. Yes, a secret you have not told many people. Your stage is yours, ma'am.
Toastmaster today, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I think if I told you the secret, it would not be a secret anymore. So I'm going to talk about the fact that I have no secrets in my life, and that is my biggest problem. Everyone knows exactly what I'm up to. Most people know exactly what my feelings are at any given moment. So I am one of those who, as the Zen master says, lives in the moment. So I'm quite happy doing whatever I am. I'm very happy sharing jokes, sharing humor with all my fellow Toastmasters, enjoying a Toastmasters meeting with absolutely no thought about what will people think about me today. What will happen to me 5 Toastmaster meetings from now? How do I get on with all my different topics? Absolutely nothing at all. What you need to know is that the person who has no secrets has nothing to fear. So it's like your life is safe because for better or worse, no scandals, no sins, no stories for newspapers, tabloids, anything else, no one, nothing for people to gossip about. So like Toastmaster Neelakanta Venu was saying, if you want to have a really good night's sleep, be a person with a clear conscience. Don't worry about your salt intake. Don't worry about anything else. Be happy, live in the day, and keep any secrets that you have out in the open. That's where they are the safest. Back to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, DTM Meena Chan.
Welcome.
So time is over. So before I'll hand over to TMOD, timer, just I want to confirm what are the people who are there for eligible for voting?
Yes, Toastmaster Satyaraj. So the qualified speakers are Toastmaster Nanda, Toastmaster Vijayarajan, Toastmaster Punit, Toastmaster Adil, and guest Sivalai Sindhil Nadan and DTM Nina John. Thank you.
Thank you, timer Sarat. Now I will hand over to meeting to TMOD. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Toastmaster, for this wonderful TG session. Now going back to, okay, what next? Albert Einstein once remarked that adversity introduces a man to himself or a woman. That's very true. What took several years, almost 5 to 10 years, with lots of medical professionals, with a lot of scientists, with a lot of researchers, everybody cracking their brain to find a solution to a problem. It was there still, but never could they bring it out so quick and so early. Day in and day out in the lab, bringing out a lot of papers, publishing scientific research, publishing scientific papers, everything, all the best brains were working together, but still they could not find an answer, at least for 5 to 10 years. Yes, my dear friends, I'm talking about the vaccine, which took several years, minimum of 5 to 10. Today, mankind has able to find a vaccine for a novel coronavirus in less than a year, or maybe a few months more than a year. So that's one positive aspect. So man, we are confident in future, if there is going to be anything similar happening, we can find a vaccine even quicker. That's the positive side of this coronavirus, of this pandemic. And we've been believing that all of us are independent. The world and the nation, everything is independent. We have our boundaries. We can live within the boundaries and we have nothing to care about. We have nothing to be fearful about as long as we are able to make 2 square meals a day and make both ends meet. That notion has been shattered. Nobody is now independent. We are interdependent, especially during these times. We need one another. We need to hold hands. We need to wipe tears from other people's eyes. We need to be the support for people who lost their loved ones. We are interdependent. That's what this pandemic has taught us. Now that we have come to the table topic session, we are going to the final segment of today's meeting, that's the general evaluation. I request our general evaluator, Toastmaster Vignesh, to please carry forward the evaluation session. Over to you, Toastmaster Vignesh.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Srikanth. Before going to the general evaluation report, and now I will request our second team for the speech evaluation. Who will evaluate the prepared speaker's speech? To evaluate Toastmaster Aishwarya's speech, I welcome Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana, who is a software engineer in Applied Materials, India, for the past 15 years. A passionate Toastmaster, I request Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayana to share his report.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vignesh. Good evening, Toastmasters and guests, and a special good evening to my target speaker, Toastmaster Aishwarya. Toastmaster Aishwarya delivered a motivational story inspired from Italian sculptor Antonio Canova, which indeed had an excellent message: never underestimate your talent. This story had key elements of a storytelling, which is 4 P's. The first one is the place, the people, plot, and purpose. The place is setting up of location where the story happened, and she mentioned it has happened in Italy. And then the people, which includes different characters in the story, each with a different role, the grandfather, grandmother, and the key character being Antonio Canova, the protagonist. And then the plot, the sequence of events that connect the audience to the protagonist, and how he practiced creating a statue out of small rock, which actually an inspiration from his grandmother's stories. And finally, how he able to create a crouching yellow lion from a butter. And then the last part is the purpose The purpose of this story is the message, they never underestimate your talent. So with this, Toastmaster Aishwarya has met the objective of the speech, where she has delivered an excellent speech. And coming to the recommendations, I have only two recommendations here. The first one is, I don't know whether others had this problem. Like, I had a little difficulty with the audio and I had to listen very carefully. I can hear what she's saying, but I had to be very keen on observing the words because there are noises behind, and actually it is helping my improve my listening skills. So probably you can check your mic, the audio and video before delivering the speech. And the second one, like as I mentioned, that you covered the place, but the story should have the setting, that is the time and location. You mentioned the location as Italy, but it would be more credible if you mentioned the time period at which the story happened, and also more details about Antonio and his achievements, so that it will add more credibility to the story you narrated. So overall, this is an excellent speech, an excellent narration of a story. I wish you all the best for your speeches. What do you generally evaluate with this?
Thank you, Toastmaster Lakshmi Narayanam. Now, to evaluate Toastmaster Ratika's speech, I welcome Toastmaster Abhilash, who is a chartered accountant by profession and a current VP of CTM. Toastmaster Abhilash, please share Toastmaster Ratika's speech report.
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator. A warm good evening to my fellow Toastmasters and to my target speaker, Toastmaster Pratika. They say speaking is the art of throwing a knife at a small target 10 miles away. And in that, persuasive speaking is doing the same thing, except that you are blindfolded. Toastmaster Pratika was attempting her persuasive speaking project today. Moving on, let me take you through what I liked about her speech and perhaps what she could have done better. The first thing was, she started off with a question, who loves potato chips? And I'm sure that, like me, many of you raised your hands. She had an excellent and riveting introduction, and she had the audience grasping her. So a good introduction. The second point was, she had excellent hand gestures throughout her speech. Was it when she displayed the Maggie on screen and told us what ill effects Maggie actually has? Or the three calls to action that she had towards the end of her speech. During almost the entire duration of her speech, her hand gestures were amazing. Moving on, there is a small fine point between where, you know, information is presented well and information becomes an overload on you. Unfortunately, today she was on the wrong line. The information that she presented, I felt, could have been presented better, and it was overloaded too. A little bit less of information would have perhaps held the audience attention. The second thing was her vocal variety. The speech was such an excellent topic. How much salt is too much salt? Even if it was simple, it is such a lively topic, and she could have had better vocal variety. For example, when she told that we had 16 times of potassium consumption early on, but now it is reduced, something like, early on, it was 16 times of what we consumed. Today, it is much less, and yet the salt content is going up. So she could have displayed better vocal variety, is what I felt. And the third point, meeting the project objectives. She was to present a persuasive speech today. However, I felt, so she was to present her L3, P1, but there were times when I was confused if she was presenting her L1, P3 on research and presentation. The project had information, unfortunately, I did not find the persuasion in her speech. The persuasion was missing today in her project. What I would feel is, while I raised my hand when she asked who loved potato chips, at the end of the speech, I was not convinced if I should leave potato chips or not. So I believe as an objective, the persuasion objective was not met, and I feel she could redo the speech with a better persuasion. So to sum up, she had an excellent introduction and good hand gestures. She could have used better vocal variety, a tone down on the information, and an increase on the persuasion, which was her objective, would have made this a much better speech. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhilash. Now to evaluate our third speaker, Toastmaster Venu's speech, I welcome Toastmaster Jimmy, who is a current treasurer of the club, working with Biocon Technology. Biocon Limited. Toastmaster Jimmy, please share your evaluation report, please.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Vignesh. Once again, namaste to everyone. So why only corporate boast about 360 degree appraisals? It is happening in CTM also. So today I am evaluating the speech of my mentor. So it's an honor and pleasure to do the evaluation today of Toastmaster Venu Nilakantan. Seeing the topic about sleep, I was like, oh, the topic is sleep and I have to be awake to evaluate it. But I must tell you, Toastmaster Venu Nilakantan, thankfully, you kept all the audience awake and engaged throughout your speech. You were able to provide a lot of significant information, that too in a very short time. We could understand the topic was a very elaborate one, but you were able to condense it into a 5 to 7 minute speech, and you were able to present it well. What I loved is the sequencing of your speech. You actually set the context well by dramatizing your own story. And then you left a thought in the mind of the audience, whether they are following the right sleep hygiene. And then you started with your presentation. So that was a real, very good sequencing of your speech. And then the slides were really good. The slides were nice and it was interesting. And then with a pinch of humor, you kept the audience engaged. And also you concluded the speech with a call for action, which was really good. And that exactly is the purpose of the speech, the researching and presenting with a call for action. So I only wish the audience should not keep awake and count your rapid eye movements and non-rapid eye movements. So if I'm to suggest on the few improvement areas, one is being a research paper, probably you could have given the references that will help help a listener to do a further research, or that can actually help the audience to pursue his interest further in the topic. The second thing is when it comes to voice modulations and variations, when you want to do it, you are a master at it. But I felt that you can actually better it, or there is a lot of scope for improvement to make it look more natural. So that is a suggestion from my side. Otherwise, I thoroughly enjoyed the speech, and there is a lot of take-home messages. Thank you very much, and good luck for the next projects. Thank you so much, and over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jimmy. Now to evaluate Toastmaster Srijit's speech, I welcome Toastmaster Nadira, who is an enthusiastic Toastmaster and also an area director and division director of a Division C. Toastmaster Nadira, please share your evaluation report.
Thank you, General Evaluator of the Day. As Alan Watts says, you can only make sense of change when you plunge into it, move with it, and join the dance. And fellow Toastmasters, trust me when I say this, they chose the wrong person to be judging this speech that to given. It's a vegan speech, and they chose the most carnivorous person alive for this. Now, all that said and done, if this vegan speech can convince the carnivore in me to maybe give veganism a shot, that means this speech has already reached half the success that it has been targeted to reach. Now, plate full of disaster. Now, keeping this in mind, your speech was like a dish that you prepared. Let's keep it as a veg biryani. You have prepared it super well and it's well presented. Now, let's move to the commendations and the recommendations. He had all his ingredients kept prepared before he started his speech. It was well researched, and you presented it with beautiful organization. You timed everything perfectly, and there was not too much of your information in one part of your segment. And at the same time, you not only presented it to make it look tempting, you also made sure that all of us wanted a little bit of it. So kudos to you on that. Now, even though any speech can be good or even great, even the greatest speech has a few things that can be tweaked to make it even more tempting. Now, keeping that your dish has reached whatever requirements that you wanted, we have a few things which can be worked. You had way too many ingredients fitted into this 7-minute speech. So what you could have done is maybe toned it down just a bit, not a lot. Even the most simplistic ingredients can give you a great dish. So that was one thing I would like for you to work on. And the next thing is your speech conclusion. You told us, let us take a stance, and it felt like your conclusion ended with just one sentence. Now, had there been an addition of just a little more garnish over there, you would have convinced us all that veganism is the way to go. Now, to sum it all up, Toastmaster Srijit Uni, your speech was absolutely tasty. And trust me, it has left a carnivore like me wanting to try it. So thank you so much. All the best for your future speeches. I hope you take my recommendations and make your dish better. Back to the general evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nadira, for a wonderful evaluation report. And now I thank all the evaluators for the detailed report. Now I call our tag team to improve our punctuality and to know more about the timing duration we took on the speech. We have our timer. I welcome Toastmaster Sharat to share his timer report.
Thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster Dinesh. So here is the detailed time report. The meeting started exactly on time at 4 p.m. And Sadhana Dams, time allotted is 2 minutes and time taken is 2 minutes. Presiding officer, time allotted is 2 minutes. Time taken is 3 minutes. TMOD, for his introduction, time allotted is 4 minutes. Time taken is 5 minutes. GE, for introduction, time allotted is 2 minutes. Time taken is 2 minutes. Court master and EDM master, allotted time is 1 to 2 minutes. The court master, Toastmaster Mugil, time taken is 1 minute 40 seconds. And Toastmaster Ashwini, time taken is 2 minutes 5 seconds. And for all the prepared speakers, the allotted time was 5 to 7 minutes. Toastmaster Aishwarya, you took 6 minutes 36 seconds. Toastmaster Ratika, you took 7 minutes 35 seconds. Toastmaster Venu, 9 minutes 6 seconds. And Toastmaster Srijit Uni, 6 minutes 38 seconds. And TT Master, time allotted was 1 minute and time taken is 1 minute for the introduction. And all the TT speakers, the allotted time was 1 to 2 minutes. And speaker number one, Toastmaster Ashwini, took 58 seconds. Toastmaster Nanda took 1 minute 14 seconds. And Toastmaster Vijayarajan took 1 minute 38 seconds. And Toastmaster Puneet took 2 minutes 19 seconds. Toastmaster Adil took 1 minute 49 seconds. Toastmaster Midun took 46 seconds. Guest Jayamurgan took 49 seconds. And guest Sivalai took 1 minute 17 seconds. And DTM Meena John took 1 minute 43 seconds. And for all the evaluation, the time allotted was 2 to 3 minutes. Toastmaster Lakshmi took 2 minutes 32 seconds. Toastmaster Abhilash took 2 minutes 48 seconds. And Toastmaster Jimmy took 2 minutes 58 seconds. And finally, Toastmaster Nadira took 2 minutes 36 seconds. So thank you so much. Over to you, G.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sharat, for the detailed report from the introduction to the ending part. To know more about verbal pauses and filler words used in the speech and today's meeting, we have our R counter with the report. I welcome Toastmaster Johnson to share the R counter report.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Once again, good evening to all the fellow Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen. Now I'm going to share my screen. Just give me a thumbs up if you can see my screen. Just give me a minute. Okay, I don't think I can share my screen because I was just tracking down all the R counting reports in an Excel sheet, but unfortunately it's not visible. But anyway, I'm going to just report verbally. So first Toastmaster Geeta, Toastmaster Srikanth Kutikrishnan, Toastmaster Nanda, Toastmaster Aishwarya, Toastmaster Ratika, Toastmaster Nanda. Please give them a huge round of applause, because they have never ever used pause fillers in their speech. Especially, I would like to appreciate Toastmaster Srikanth Kutikrishnan, because he is the master of this ceremony. He is the hero of today's meeting, and he has never used a pause filler right from the beginning of his right from the beginning of the meeting. Please give them a big round of applause. And I would like to mention few other names whom they need to improve: Toastmaster Vignesh and Toastmaster Mugil, Toastmaster Venu, Srijit Unni, Lakshmi Narayanan, Toastmaster Abhilash, and Akash, Toastmaster Chirag, Toastmaster Satyaraj, and Toastmaster Sivalai, guest DTM Nina John, and they have used a few pass fillers, and they are the persons who has to improve their speech. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Johnson, for the informative report. To know about today's grammar usage and feedback, I call our grammarian Toastmaster Chirag to share his report. Over to Toastmaster Chirag.
Thank you, General Evaluator. When you are so much good speakers, it is so difficult to note down all the phrases and all these things. So I tried my best. So with starting with this Toastmaster Srikanth Kutikrishnan, he has used so many phrases, I lost count. So he has used turn turtle, shattered, hide and seek, human will, adaptability, collective humanity. And other speakers also, fascinate, awestruck, dormant. Toastmaster Vratika has used many biological terms, which I have not understood. But she has used many good phrases and words also: in the same boat, hunter-gatherers, dietary balance, alleviated, satiation. She has used proverb like give neither counsel nor salt. So moving on to Toastmaster Venu, he has also used on the same boat, rapid, rejuvenate, segregates, omnipresence. There were so many good words. Even my I have very short page, I couldn't track everything. Moving on to Srijit Unni, he has used very good words like self-imposed frontier of humanity, subjective, wreck, havoc, trivial, jiffy, imperative. These were good usages. Moving on to not so good usages, I couldn't find any except one. When you are telling any past event, will should not be used. So either you should use would or any was or were, these types of words. You should not use will in the when you're telling past event. So that's all from my side. Thank you, General Evaluator, for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, Toastmaster Chirag, for the wonderful report. Okay, now we are into the general evaluation report. To tell about today's meeting, we have a detailed agenda get from VPE from 2 days back. So that was with a new format and a very detailed timing and roles. So it was wonderful. I appreciate Toastmaster Blush. And the meeting was started at sharp 4 o'clock as per the schedule. Thanks to Sergeant Atam to start the meeting at the correct time and muting the everyone before time. Also thank everyone to present as per the schedule. And it was good that introducing the guest at initially was means good guest also be engaged with the meeting, so they also get participated introduced at the beginning will be they can understood the process and they turned on the video. That was good. And the TMOD's theme selection was in line with the current situation. So what's next? So, and the meeting idioms, he used like turn turtle, pinch of salt. So which some of them were previously we used idioms. So he kept using that idioms for reminding us to use this not only on the particular meeting. So we have to use that what we used the previous meeting. So that was good. I appreciate him, and he handles the meeting with a very smooth transition while switching from one speaker to another speaker. So I appreciate him. And about quote master and idiom master chooses a good quote and idioms. And also I appreciate the way they put the quote and idiom on the chat box. Toastmaster Aishwarya did a good speech, like looks aren't everything. So she did a motivational speech. The thing I would recommend her is to keep some separate mic so that it will voice will be more clear. Toastmaster Radhika was a very informative speech about taking care about salty food, which dominates other tastes. So I appreciate that term. So and also I request Toastmaster Aishwarya and Ratika and Srijit to involve themselves into the speech would be more good, so we can in line with the speaker apart from their content. So rather than saying something which we read from somewhere or saying the story, we can involve the content with ourselves. That would be more engaging and we will be interesting to hear a lot from them. Toastmaster Venu did that. So he initially started saying with sleeping disorder he having and his wife asking about so that is very engaged, right? So it was very interesting. So I like appreciate him about that speech content. And TT Master, I appreciate him that way he engaged with the audience. Like initially he asked Abhilash and Ashwini and Toastmaster Nanda to tell about play a role about Toastmaster Abhilash on the spot. So it was very interesting and unexpected in the TT session. So it was good. And also I appreciate the way he is giving importance to the guest rather than the our members in the TT session. So it was really appreciable. And all the TT speakers did a very amazing job about TT Master, TT speaker Puneet, Adil, and TTM Nina John. So I appreciate the way they handled the tough topic into very convincing content. Then about the recommendation, right? So one more thing, timer did a very good job. So he keep tracking of the content from initially to the end of the meeting. So usually many of us what we do, right, only the speaker's time only we will notice, but he is noting about all the intro and every speech content because of the schedule agenda we get, right? So he kept track of the everything. So I thank Toastmaster Abhilash and timer for the good thing. And I request speakers to use the word of the day. I didn't get any word of the day in the meter. And also requested to try to use idioms shared by our idiom master. And TT Master, about saying topics by reading, you can share the screen and ask the members to pick the number and then reveal the topic. So that will be more curious and interesting for the TT session. And speakers, that's all. I thank my evaluation team and tag team for the wonderful evaluation report. And thanks everyone. Over to Toastmaster Toastmaster of the day, Srikant.
Thank you very much, General Evaluators. Toastmasters and guests, this is what I want to leave you with. Yes, we are going through very tough times in these days. I don't know how long it would last. We only pray that it is a very short period that we come out of this. But I always request each one of you to be there for everyone that is around you, your family, your friends. We need to hold hands together. We need to face this challenge together simply for the reason that the planet Earth that we are using right now is only a planet Earth that we have borrowed from the generation that is following us. We have merely taken it from them, and we need to give back to the generation or the children that is coming behind us, the generation following us. We should give them a planet which is safe, which is secured, with all the abundance and beauty that the Creator has created for all of us. It's my wish and my prayer that each one of you and your family members are safe and sound wherever you are. Take care of your health, and I'm sure we stand united and we are going to overcome this by any cost. Thank you very much. I thoroughly enjoyed being your host. Thank you once again. Stay home and stay safe. Good night. Back to you, presiding officer, Toastmaster Abhilash.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Srikanth, for having taken the meet across in a wonderful manner with all your introductions and transitions. Close on a meet well conducted. It is now time for us to hear some quick feedback from our guests. So let us start off. Toastmaster Atiban, guest Atiban, could you unmute yourself and tell us how the meeting went?
Yeah, good evening and thank you, team. So this was my first virtual meeting for the Toastmaster. So I really, I just gone through the agenda which has been shared previously by someone in the WhatsApp group. So I just gone through the agenda. I thought that I don't know how I'm just going to understand all these things, but it was quite good and it is well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. So please do come for more meetings. You'll definitely get to know better. Next up, guest Niveta.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Hello. Yes, we can hear you. Perfect.
Yes. Thank you so much for having me. I mean, it was very insightful. I would probably say that this is the first meeting that I've ever attended after a really long time, apart from the office meetings and, you know, all these, apart from all those professional things. So it was lovely to hear everyone's speeches and topics, and everything was very informative. And I didn't take it as like, you know, there were so many evaluators and people who are going through it. I was looking just for the information, the way they were speaking, the hand gestures and everything, because I'm a newbie. I didn't know how to, you know, like learn exactly with using those points and all. But it was very insightful. And I would also like to thank Abhirami for, you know, coordinating. She was very sweet. And, you know, I messaged her. I dropped a message and she was very quick and responsive. And she was also, you know, helping me with all my questions. I hope I didn't, you know, barge in with so many questions. So thank you so much. Looking forward to, you know, so many meetings with you all.
Thank you. Thank you, Niveta. Looking forward to hosting you for more such
thank
meetings.
You. Thank you.
Thank you. Jayam, guest Jayam Murugan. Could we hear from you?
Hi, all. To keep it very simple, it was structured and perfect. In all aspects, and thanks to Ms. Abhirami, who actually I dropped a message yesterday and I immediately got the meeting. The response was really quick and fast, and I could see the involvement here. Nothing improves without the involvement, and of course the great energy level is shown here. That's really amazing.
Thank you so much, Jay Murugan. Do come for our meetings.
Sure.
Thank you. Timer is ready. All right. So next up, so can we hear from Shivalay?
Yes, it was really good and I'm captivating or getting fully involved. And I really enjoyed it. And I was attending about 4 years back with WetSmiths. And there also and here also, I was praying myself that I should not be called for TT, but I have been called. And I underwent through that roller coaster in that process. And I really enjoyed it. I'm really happy that I want to get back into Toastmasters journey. So thank you. It was really
thank
wonderful
you.
Experience.
Thank you, Shivala. You know, CTM, the TT stage is like, if you don't wish then that will, the opposite will come through. So have to be doubly careful. So last, I guess Siddheshwar. All right. So let's continue on with the next part of the closing session. So a few, one first time role player today, we had Toastmaster Chirag, who has played the role of grammarian for the first time. So please give him a huge round of applause. We have two milestone speeches today. Toastmaster Venu, so this is not a new milestone for him, but he's completed his first level in his third path motivational strategies. So huge inspiration, congratulations. And Toastmaster Shrijit, who's completed his first level in persuasive influence. A huge round of applause. Congratulations, Toastmaster Venu and Shrijit, for finishing your level ones. Moving on, one announcement. We will be having our business meeting, semi-annual business meeting on 20th June, where we'll be giving the report. So requesting everyone to attend without fail. Official notice will be coming from our secretary. Now, moving on to the final session, so the awards for today. So the best quote or idiom master for today is our idiom master for today, Toastmaster Ashwini, for giving us such wonderful idioms and also keeping track of the word amazing today. Congratulations, Toastmaster Ashwini. Our best tag role player for today, a very senior Toastmaster who's returned back to us with such energy that we were all amazed by his detailed timer report. Timer, Toastmaster Sharat is our best tag role player for today. The best role player for today, the one who had a plot twist. So I was more nervous than having to actually speak in table topics. So that was the level of nervousness he put me into. Our table topic master, Toastmaster Satyaraj, is the best role player for today. Congratulations, Toastmaster Satyaraj. Moving on, the best evaluator for today, the most carnivorous evaluator to evaluate a vegan speech. Congratulations, Toastmaster Nadira, our best evaluator. And so the best table topic speaker, so who do you think it is going to be? Any guesses? All right, so the best table topic speaker, so today we had, actually it was a tie, two champion speakers in their own right, so it was a tie for table topics. Toastmaster Puneet and Toastmaster Adil both were best table topic speakers, but due to the casting vote, Toastmaster Adil, you can reach out to Toastmaster Geeta why she didn't vote for you. Toastmaster Puneet is the best TT speaker. And finally, our best speaker for today, so a person who's completed his first milestone in Toastmasters, Toastmaster Shrijit is the best speaker for today. Congratulations, Toastmaster Shrijit. Wishing you more luck on your future milestones. And with this, we come to the end of today's meeting. Today's meeting was an amazing meeting. All our role players did an excellent job. Looking forward to more such meetings with all of you. And on this note, let me adjourn meeting 780 to next week, Sunday, same time, 4 to 6. Let's now meet for an informal session.